big donations and fundraising events. So we are floating with that. And if you want to accomplish any of these events, we need your support like what you have done today. So for change, it's our highest priority. I know many of the devotees during the special days, they don't even want to come to the temple. They call me, send me an email. We are trying our best. As you all know, Town of Kerry is so tough to get anything approved. So it takes ages to get anything approved. But we are working. Probably in a month or so, we will have at least 150 parking spaces. So that should be enough for our devotees to come and have a pleasant time at the temple. The next is Shiva Temple. As you all know, Shiva Temple is very old now. And it's like a money pit. So every time we touch, we have to spend lots of money. So we have different plans. One plan is we are planning to demolish that and build a new temple in the same place, which would last at least 10, 15 years or 20 years. The planning it's at the mercy of Town of Kerry. If they approve, definitely you're going to see new Shiva Temple within the first half of 2013. And what we are talking here is, if you want to sustain such a big temple, such a big community, big devotee crowd who comes to the temple, you cannot depend on hoodie collections, peace services or fundraising events. Like majority of the temples in the United States, they stop doing fundraising because they raise enough income from cafeteria. So that will cover all the overheads. They hardly do any fundraising. So we are working very hard to start at least what we call gathering place. That's what Town of Kerry wants us to call until we have a full-fledged cafeteria. So that is in the process. Now we are doing fundraising for Kalyan Mandapam. This is a multi-complex, as I told you before, that includes cafeteria, Kalyan Mandapam, Gurukulam, and administrative offices, which will generate enough income to cover our majority of the expenses so that we don't have to depend on other sources for running the temple. Gurukulam campus, this is another one we are doing off-site, and temple, SV Temple management would like to have Gurukulam at SV Temple campus. So once we have Kalyan Mandapam, community center, whatever you call, so we are going to have all the Gurukulam classes at the temple, which would be more ideal, and majority of the parents express they want Gurukulam at the temple, which hopefully soon we will fulfill the dream. Rajagopuram. Rajagopuram has a specific time. We have to finish that in a timely fashion. That is 2018, and some people say 2017, we have to finish building Rajagopuram. That will complete our Srivari temple. Until then, Srivari temple is not complete. Then Shiva Parivar, we need a beautiful temple like Srivari temple for Shiva temple. That is, we are hoping if everything goes well, 2022, so we will have beautiful temple like Srivari temple for Shiva and Ganesha. Rich quarters in 2025, and SVD foundation like humanitarian, religious, spiritual education, once we accomplish all this. Couple of things I already mentioned, projects underway, Shiva temple construction, new plans for constructing 3,000 square foot building in the same old temple. And we are going to increase at least 150 car parkings on both sides, 9405 and 9455 houses which have acquired these properties recently. And we are planning to, and some of the, I see lots of previous board members here, they all know how much money we spend for renting tents for big events. Our community has grown, we need a really big tent. It costs $8,000 to $10,000 every time we rent a tent. We used to spend almost $40,000 to $60,000 per year. Since 18 months, we have not rented any big tent so far, and we are trying to manage inside our big temple and other facilities to save the money. And once we have shelter and gazebo type, so we can save more money too. Again, cafeteria, which I mentioned, that's a gathering place, that's what Town of Kerry wants. Until we have full-fledged, full-fledged cafeteria, it costs 150 to 200 thousand. Children's play area, we are in the process of getting permission for that. And the most important thing is Dignity Center for Senior Citizens. Again, we are talking, we started about 3 months ago. Radhakrishna Pudra Garu is the in charge of that. This is basically, this is, Triangle has become a retirement place. Lots of parents, those who have worked in this country, they are coming to study here. There are lots of parents, in-laws, visiting this place and staying in this place. So we are trying to have a get-together at the temple once a week so that they can exchange their thoughts and all their life experience and have some activities at the temple. And also they can do some volunteering at the temple too. So that is in process. I would request every devotee, if you have parents, elders, visitors from India, please send an email to us. So we will get in touch with the Radhakrishna Pudra Garu. It's an excellent, lots of parents and elders are appreciating that. So please help us. It's free. So we provide all the facilities and all the activity, whatever you need for the activities, we provide that. It's free. And once we have enough funds, we may have SV Temple vehicle to pick them up and drop them up in the future.
Just trying to make a dollar. That's all.
9445, this property was purchased in 2011. That is entirely from the funds raised during last gala. We did not borrow any single penny from the bank. All the money we paid full cash for that. And it's giving us lots of room for expansion for our temple. And 9405, that is the house we own. Temple owned that property. Demolished old home, leveled it. And we are creating more than 70 car parks in that area. You might have seen the work progress in that area. Probably in a couple of weeks we should have. We should be able to park there in that area. The Tirumala walkway, that is, we have got two properties there, so we needed a connection between the properties and the main temple, so we built that. That is helping lots of visitors and people who use 9455 for the bridge services. So that's an excellent thing, that lots of people appreciated that. And the new thing, as we are growing in big time on the temple and people are donating lots of jewels, abharnas, lots of things to the temple, and we have acquired lots of assets to all these years. So we have asset management, asset and inventory management. We take photographs, weight and numbering. So almost 90% of the asset inventory has been done. So probably we will have 100% probably in a couple of months. All the volunteers, they do a good job. So we own this property, 9455, that is the house you see when you enter the temple, 9445. We bought this property last year. And this is where we demolished the house, so we are going to move some of the dirt here, and we make more car parking here, about 70-75 car parking. One good news is, we were paying until last month 6.2% mortgage for $2 million loan to build a beautiful temple. We still owe the North State Bank, and with lots of negotiations, however, we managed to bring down the interest to 4%. We'll be saving $42,000 a year in the mortgage, and that will help us tremendously. One more good news is, with reducing the interest in 10 years, the $2 million loan will be paid off. So we don't owe anything on our beautiful Shiva Srivaru temple in 10 years. I don't know how many of you know, we spent more than $75,000 for flowers every year. We started Padmavati Garden. I'm sure some of you have noticed, we are putting lots of flowering plants all around the temple, and we have beautiful Rose garden, months and lots of plants, Tulsi gardens. So that this year we almost saved almost $20,000 in saving for not buying loose flowers or extra garlands for big events. So all the effort from all the volunteers for that. We started a development fund last year during our first gala. That is working very well. Even after buying that property, we still have $150,000 in that account. what we do, all the major donations you give, that money goes straight to the development fund. We use it for the development of the temple. We started Gurukulam Fund because then lots of parents approached me, so we pay so much money, what's happening to what the money you save from Gurukulam? So they said if you have a Gurukulam Fund, they're going to donate more, they're going to support for Gurukulam. We started that, I think this year, so it is growing very well. So thanks to everyone for that. Other thing is, ours is a non-profit organization. We are entitled for tax refund. So we are working very, very hard to get the refund. We got first tax refund, sales tax refund, $18,000. Second half of 2008, that's what we were eligible. And we are processing some more. Maybe we should be getting more than 100K once we file all the papers in sales tax refund to the temple. So that's volunteers are working very hard, and we are going to see much, much more funds coming from them. This is total cash reserves. In December 2009, we had $126,330 in our all our accounts. That was, so we have two banks and some stock options and some deposits. So we had this. And with all your support and community at large, everyone you support, we were able to sustain and pay off all the expenses. And we paid off almost $40,000 to $50,000 in mortgage, principal amount. And still, every year we are growing. And now we have more than $635,000 cash reserves in our accounts. So thanks to all of you for your support. As I said, Temple Development Fund, we have done lots of improvements with all your support and financial support and all the work we have extended to the temple. One is, I'm sure everyone who have visited the temple within the last month or so, the concrete flooring inside the Prakaram, everything is complete, and it was so joyful to see. We said the Srivari birthday, people were dancing, all those things, excellent. So, hope you enjoy going around temple and the productions and everything. We did lots of beautification, we did painting inside and painting of the compound, you would have seen now, and lighting outside. And roofing, this was a big issue for the past 3-4 years, roofing. Finally, with the grace of God, we managed to figure out and roofing and stop. This is the third month since we don't have a clear drop of roofing. I'm sure some of you are happy because they were really angry when they see me. What am I doing? So finally, we managed that. It's working well. Donor wall, another thing. So 3 years we were waiting. Finally, a couple of weeks ago, we installed. I'm sure for all of, many of you attended that. And so those donors who have we invited all the donors for that. If you didn't come for the event, you see me, so we have some goodie bags for all the donors. If your name is on the donor wall, you'll get a goodie bag. Painting, and we did illumination. It was so dark at night time, so we did lots of illumination. And Padmavati Garden, please walk around the temple. Next time when you are at the temple, you will see all the flower beds. It's beautiful. And if you want to contribute for the flower garden, see me. And we purchased 2 golf carts. Because our parks are, car parks are going to be a little far away, we want to help elderly or disabled or those who cannot walk from there. Ashok, 2 more minutes. So to help people, so we have golf carts, volunteers will bring them from car park to the temple and from temple to the car park. So with all your support, you can see what we are doing, where we are now. See, in 1998, this was the temple, Srivari temple. 1998. Look at here, where we are. So, if you continue to support, we will achieve all the strategic plans I showed you on the list, and we will have one of the best temples in the United States, and everybody will enjoy. These are some of the Tirumala walkway. This is all the concrete we put in inside the temple. It's easy to walk. And less painful. This is just the last week we did this Vimana Venkateshwara. I'm sure when you're driving to the temple you can see out there. And this was lots of people's day, so we accomplished that. This is our donor wall. I'm sure I see lots of people, so give it clap. Big applause for everyone, for the name. If any name is missing, or if you want your name, see me. We will order one more board. We hired two new priests. Shiva temple will be able to conduct religious services at the temple and outside. And our staff is growing. Our temple is growing, staff is growing. So we decided to have time management, time cards at the temple. So it's working very well. And it's also disciplinary. And we just October 1st, we hired a full-time manager, Meena Mohan. He is very, very dedicated. We hired her. So, and we are part of Triangle Area Hindu Temple Society. We do three events, Hindu Bhavan, SV Temple and PAPS. Hindu Bhavan does Health Mela. We do Kids Summit. I'm sure lots of your kids have taken part in that. That's going very well. And we are having Kids Summit on December 9th at Cypress Center, so please watch for newsletter. Our temple is a monument and it has become an icon in Triangle, North Carolina and also East, from Atlanta up to Washington. The people who travel on I-40, everybody, lots of people, they stop and want to visit our temple. All the university kids, high school kids, college kids, if they want to do some theses or religious papers or something, we are getting requests almost a daily basis. We have an excellent PR team. They take them around the temple and explain and answer their questions. It's working very well. And we are increasing activities, especially religious activities and other activities in the temple. Our Gurukulam is our prideful part of the SV temple. We have 264 students and many volunteers. Teachers, high school volunteers, administrators. We have different classes. And they do lots of workshops and charity work also, making sandwiches for poor people, homeless people. And they are an extremely active school, very disciplined school. And it's growing very well with all your support. Our communication it's under our pride part of SV Temple until couple of years ago, only about 3% or 5% of devotees used to even open newsletters. Now we are almost close to 50%. It's working very well. And the excellent newsletters, and our communication team is doing an extremely good job. And we will have a beautiful website soon. Board of Governors. I'm sure everyone remembers this. Due to our policies, constitution, we need two-thirds majority. But we got more than 50%, that is not enough to pass anything. It is a safety clause in our bylaws, so that we had a democratic election, so we got more than 50%. Until we get 65%, we cannot pass this in the constitution, change the constitution. So that stands there, so probably in the future we come back to that. I would like to thank all the sponsors, all the devotees, volunteers, and also many, many hundreds of people helped to make this event a successful. It takes a long time to make individually, so I want to thank each and everyone who helped us directly or indirectly to make this event successful. Please give him a big hand.